Can I start?
Yes.
So good afternoon, everyone. Once again, we are back. The topic of today's session is FAQs of diabetes and diet. Globally, diabetes, a lifestyle disorder, is increasing, and so the myths, doubts, and misconceptions associated with diabetes are increasing. And these myths and doubts needs to be cleared. Diet plays a major role in the management of diabetes. Whether you are trying to prevent or control diabetes, your nutritional needs are virtually the same as everyone else. So no special foods are necessary, but yes, you need to pay attention to your food choices, most notably the carbs you eat. Losing just about 5 to 10% of weight can help you lower your blood glucose levels, blood pressures, and cholesterol. Losing weight and eating healthier can also have a profound effect on your mood, energy, and sense of well-being. People with diabetes have nearly the double the risk of heart disease and are at a greater risk of developing mental health disorders, such as depression. A number of cases of type 2 diabetes are preventable, and some can even be brought to remission. And even if you already have diabetes, it's not too late to have a positive change by eating healthier, being more physically active, and losing weight, and you can achieve good glucose control and reduce the risk of complications. A diabetic diet doesn't have to be complicated, and you don't need to have to give up all your favorite foods. The first step is to make smarter choices, is to separate these myths from the facts about eating to prevent or control. And so here we are to get answers to most frequently asked questions in diabetes. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Kirti. Good afternoon, everyone.
Welcome, Kavita.
Hello, Dr. Kirti. Good afternoon, everyone.
So, sir, my first question to you today is, why is diet so important in the management of diabetes?
See, basically, okay. So first thing is we have to understand what is diabetes. Diabetes is a disturbance or derangement of the normal metabolic process that is happening in the body. Now, whatever we eat, whatever food we eat, gets converted into two components. One is the source of energy, which is usually glucose. Glucose is the most important source of energy utilized by various tissues and cells. So whatever food we eat gets converted into ultimately glucose to be utilized as energy. Now, whatever is left or is surplus after energy needs gets stored as fat. So once there is derangement in this normal metabolic process, there is increase in the glucose production, which is not utilized, and there is increase in blood glucose level. Now, in normal case, whatever glucose is produced from food is utilized as energy or gets stored as fat or glycogen. And this is a very closely, with very intricate network of hormones, nervous system, and various functions of body, which maintain a normal level. Now, this system has become now deranged. So the system is not able to control the metabolic process maintaining a normal glucose level. Now, if you are eating, say, more, then you are producing more glucose. And it is more difficult to control it because the system is not working and you will need more medication or more complex treatment strategies to do it. Second thing is, if you change your food intake on day-to-day basis, now what we are trying to do is with medication, control the X amount of glucose that is produced by consuming Y amount of food. Now, if your consumption of food moves from Y to Y plus 10, your glucose production also goes up, but your medication is fixed. So you will have more glucose levels because this medication is not sufficient. In a normal individual, body is automatically regulating all this. This regulation is missing. And we cannot completely regulate it by medication. So we have to focus on, consistent, healthy diet which does not disturb the glucose level significantly and is easily manageable by treatment. That is why diet is one of the key components for managing diabetes.
Right, sir. So the next question is for Kavita. What is a good diet for a diabetic patient?
Hello, Dr. Kirti. So as sir explained that diet is a very important factor in diabetes management. So nutritional needs of the person with having diabetes and a non-diabetic person are same. So no special foods are necessary, but you need to pay attention on your food choices and the amount desired should be rich in whole grains, fruits, vegetables, legumes, nuts, packaged foods. Also, we have a very, I have also explained
I think Kavita's your voice is breaking. Yes. I think there is some problem with signals at your level. Can you repeat it, what you just said?
Yes. Sir, abhi aa rahi hai awaaz?
Yes, it's clear now, Kavita.
So I was telling about the diet in diabetes. It plays a very important role in diabetes management. As the nutritional requirements of a non-diabetic person and a person having diabetes are more or less same. So there are no special foods required, but we have to pay attention on the kind of food and the amount of food what we are having. So a good diet is basically rich in fiber. It is rich in complex carbs, more of legumes, green leafy vegetables and fruits. Here we have, and it is less, a person with diabetes should avoid free sugars and processed and packaged foods. So we have a concept of a healthy plate here in which we have half of the plate of fruits and vegetables. 1/4 portion should be comprising of lean proteins and 1/4 portion of whole grain cereals. So this is a good diabetic diet which a person should have to manage diabetes.
Can you show the plate?
Yes, sir. Just a second. So this is the plate. Here we can see that half of the plate is filled with fruits and veggies. 1/4 is of lean protein and 1/4 is of whole grain cereals.
So that gives a balanced
diet. Ideal diet.
That gives a balanced, healthy diet.
Yes.
So, so Kavita, what I can make it out is your diet is basically of carbs, fats, and proteins.
Yes.
So now I would like you to focus on a particular group and give detailed information. Let's start with carbs. So what type of carbohydrates should be included in diet and what are the good carbs which should be included?
See, a major portion of our energy from our food comes from carbohydrates and it is around 50 to 55% of the total calorie intake. So a person with diabetes can eat carbs, but important thing is that which type of carbs and amount of carbs the patient is having. Like carbs, if I explain carbs, there are three types. There are complex carbs, we have simple carbs, we have refined carbs. So simple and refined carbs are simple sugars which give a instant rise in the sugar levels. And complex carbs are rich in fiber, they have more of vitamins and minerals and they give a sustained release of energy. So they don't cause more spike in sugars. So examples are we have whole grain cereals like we have oats, dalia, millets. And so these are all examples of good carbs which we can include in a diet instead of refined sugars. So they can give a sustained release of energy, give us a level of satiety, and we feel fuller for longer periods.
So would you like to add anything in it?
No, I think what Kavita just told is important to keep in mind. it is, you know, most of the people, when they come for treatment and you tell them to consult a dietitian or a nutritionist, तो जनरली जवाब ये होता है कि मेरे को डॉक्टर साहब हमें पता है हम कुछ ऐसा कुछ नहीं खाते, हम मीठा भी नहीं खाते, आलू भी नहीं खाते, चावल भी नहीं खाते. सो आई थिंक मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग हियर इज व्हाट इज द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ दीज थ्री मैक्रोन्यूट्रिएंट्स. देयर आर थ्री मेजर मैक्रोन्यूट्रिएंट्स व्हिच आर मेजर कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ डाइट: कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स, प्रोटीन्स एंड फैट्स. सो कार्बोहाइड्रेट एक्चुअली इंडिया जो है हमारा, वी आर लार्जली अ कार्ब ईटिंग पॉपुलेशन. यू नो व्हाट वी कॉमनली टेल आर डिस्कस विद आर फ्रेंड्स एंड टेल इन मीटिंग्स दैट वी ईट कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स विद कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स. वी ईट चपाती विद दाल, वी ईट चपाती विद यू नो वेजिटेबल्स. दीज आर वेरी पुअर सोर्सेज ऑफ प्रोटीन. दे हैव लार्ज कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स बट नो प्रोटीन्स. Right, we will eat dalia, and dalia with mixed with some vegetable. The mostly people are vegetarian. Those who are non-vegetarian, they eat meat or meat products maybe once a week. So largely out of 21 meals, 20 meals are vegetarian meals. So there are studies which have shown that our carb consumption is in the range of 65% of total caloric intake on an average. Whether it is north, south, east, west, across India, that is the percentage of carb consumption. So these carbs are going to contribute to increase in blood sugar, and these are considered as one of the reasons why we have higher levels of sugar also. Second thing is, because if you have more carbs, in after the meal, your shoot up of glucose is higher, which is difficult to control. So ideal diabetic diet should contain about 50-55% of carbohydrates. So your carbohydrate consumption has to be reduced, and your protein consumption has to be added up to make it 15-20%. Similarly, fat consumption should not be more than 25-30% of the total caloric intake. So this balancing has to be, you know, planned by a good dietitian only. A person who does not have much knowledge about diet and dietary components cannot plan a diet, and that's why a professional, professionally, you know, advised diet plan is more important for management of diabetes than just the routine manipulations.
So you said we people are eating carbs with carbs. Yes. So Kavita, I would like to know what changes should be in the diet, or what should be the proper diet like.
Sir, as sir has told that the total carb intake from our daily calories should be not more than 50-55%. There should be, as I explained in healthy diet plate, there should be one portion of lean protein also in the diet, more of fruits and vegetables, so that there should be no sharp spike in the glucose levels. Also, we should start our meals with salads, which are rich in fiber. In between the meals, we can have sprouts, we can have roasted chana to munch the cravings, so that we don't overindulge in having our bigger meals. Portion control of the meals and the timing of the meals should be proper. So,
sir, I would like to know from you, how can we add protein more into the diet? What are the sources of protein?
So vegetarian proteins, you know, soya is one of the important sources. Then increased consumption of legumes can help with the more protein intake. We can, add tofu, which is now available. Earlier, it used to be difficulty getting tofu. Somebody can take paneer. Paneer is cottage cheese, which has a high amount of protein. This is for pure vegetarian. Now, a large number of people are also eggetarian.
Yes.
So if you eat egg, consumption of 2 egg whites every day adds very good protein to your diet. So these small changes can help in improving the protein intake.
Can formula proteins be of help into it?
People who are not taking adequate protein, yes, the protein modified fast diets, they are called PMFs, protein modified fast diets, they can be used to supplement or replace meals to provide adequate protein.
So So now I would like to come to the next group, that is fats. What is the amount of fat which is required in our diet, and what type of fat should be used?
Kavita, you want to answer?
Yes, sir. So fats are basically a rich source of calories. They are a dense source of calories. So we should include them in our diet, but in limited amounts. Right. So permissible amount of fat intake should not be more than 3 teaspoons per person per day. And healthy fats like unsaturated fats found in they are found in many vegetable oils and seed oils. Like we have olive oil, groundnut oil, sesame oil, rice bran oil. We can include nuts also, and fish if we are a non-vegetarian, and walnuts also in our diet. So these are all the healthy sources of fats, but limited permissible amount should be taken into account.
So important thing is, you know, the distribution of oils, that is also important, so that you get adequate ratios of polyunsaturated fatty acids, monounsaturated fatty acids, and the omega-3, omega-6 ratios, you know. These are technical terms, but these are important to understand that you there is no single oil which gives you the best ratio. The closest to the best are, you know, rice bran oil, soya oil is good, even mustard oil is very good. So these oils can be consumed. Best is to use a mixture of oils or keep changing oils every few days. And the overall consumption should not be more than two-third of the oil should be the, you know, vegetable oil or unsaturated fats, and one-third should be saturated fats, which people will ask, you know, main ghee kha sakta hun ya butter kha sakta hun. So the total consumption per day should not exceed more than one-third of the total consumption of fat in terms of ghee and butter. Two-thirds should be oil. And simple way to tell patients is that total consumption per month per person should not increase more than 500 grams, of which one-third should be the ghee or butter and two-thirds should be the oil. So that makes it about 15 grams per day.
So practically, if we talk of, we can tell ki aap dal mein ya roti mein desi ghee use kar sakte hain, sukhi chapati ek oil, sukhi sabji ek oil mein bana sakte hain, and liquid sabji ke liye alag oil rakh sakte hain. So that will be blend of three
actually,
oils.
Actually, if you try to analyze the traditional Indian cooking,
yes,
this was very close to the idea.
Yes.
You know, people didn't have much access to the various variety of vegetables or variety of foods. So the curry vegetables were cooked in groundnut oil, dry vegetables were cooked in the mustard oil, and for application on bread was the butter or ghee. And you know, if you want to kind of put tadka, that was done by ghee. But now everything, despite remaining same, has become in excess. So earlier, there used to be small amount of ghee in large amount of dal. Now there is large amount of ghee in small amount of dal. So that has changed the whole story. And the exercise is totally missing.
Yes.
So that is what is causing a lot of problem.
Very true, sir. Now, very important question. Does a strict diabetic diet means eliminating sugars totally from the diet?
So we can have sweets as long as they are part of the healthy eating plan and we don't overindulge. Like humko agar ek bite leni hai to aisa nahi hai ki hum do ya teen tukde kha jaye uske. So that we can adjust in our meal plans. Aur hum ye bolte hain ki meals ke baad agar aapko kuch meetha khana hai to ek chota tukda gud ka le sakte hain ya petha le sakte hain sir bolte hain. या कॉटेज चीज से बनी हुई मिठाइयां ले सकते हैं. अगर रसगुल्ला खा रहे हैं तो उसका पानी निकाल के आप उसको ले सकते हैं. सो वी कैन, अगर हम कस्टर्ड बना रहे हैं तो उसमें हम शुगर फ्री ऐड कर सकते हैं या लिटिल अमाउंट ऑफ शुगर विद स्किम्ड मिल्क यूज कर सकते हैं. सो ज्यूडिशियसली वी कैन एंजॉय द स्वीट्स ऑल्सो एंड वी कैन इंक्लूड देम इन अ हेल्दी डाइट प्लान.
Would you like
it is very important. Second thing is you have to keep in mind what sweet you are taking. Now we get, you know, sugar-free ice creams also, but they are loaded with fat. What is ice cream? Ice cream has a lot of fat. It has cream, which is saturated fat. Now, so portion size has to be also very important. You can't is, you know, just because it is sugar-free ice cream, you can't eat two bowls of ice cream. You have to have a small portion. Same is with the quantity of, you know, sweets that you are taking. As Kavita rightly pointed out, have a small bite. Just, you know, have these things to have your taste, satisfaction of taste, not to fill up your stomach. Because they are all loaded, all traditional Indian sweets have a lot of ghee, a lot of calories, which is bad. It is not just sugar. Somebody wants to have, you know, half spoon of sugar in a cup of tea and takes about 3-4 cups of tea is not a problem. Up to 3-4 spoons of sugar divided into multiple times per day are not a problem if diabetes patient is consuming. Usually, you know, you will come to a situation, somebody comes with cough and you tell, ye wala cough syrup le lo. Doc sahab, mere ko to sugar hai. So having one spoon of cough syrup is not going to change the sugar values drastically. And you are not going to drink the whole bottle in one go. You have to take only one spoon 3-4 times a day. So small amount of sugar intake does not actually cause much problem. Problem is when you take a lot of sugar or you consume, you know, sugar combined with the oil or butter or ghee, that adds lots of calories. And ultimately, all these calories need to be neutralized in body to maintain a normal glucose level.
That means I can take free sugar if I am a diabetic.
Yes, you can take. Only thing is portion size is to be controlled and it should not be large amount in one go. You can take 20 grams divided in 4 cups of tea during the day. But if you take 20 grams in one cup of tea, that will cause a lot of problems.
Whenever we are doing a diet counseling session, we always say, khana time se khao, khana miss nahi karo, khana baant ke khao. So now I would like to know the importance of all these points. Coming to the first point, why is consistency so important in the diet?
So, sabse pehla isme point yehi hai ke we are on medication. So, agar hum khana nahi khayenge, to sugars may dip. Aur portion control, ek bari mein aap zyada kha rahe hain, और दूसरी बारी में आपने मील ही नहीं लिया तो उससे शुगर्स में हमारी वेरिएशन आ जाएगी. सो पहला पॉइंट हम यही पेशेंट्स को बोलते हैं कि डोंट स्किप योर मील्स, डोंट फास्ट एंड डोंट फीस्ट. एक बारी में बड़ा मील नहीं लेना है और ज्यादा देर तक भूखे पेट नहीं रहना है ताकि शुगर्स में हमारी वेरिएशंस ना आए और जो मेडिकेशन हम अकॉर्डिंगली ले रहे हैं तो शुगर्स में हमारी डिप ना आए. So this is major factor we tell our patients to be consistent with their diet so that we can keep the medication accordingly.
So would you like to add something?
Yeah, so it is very important. Hota kya hai ki most of the time we try to give medication in morning and evening. And whatever, whether we are giving morning, afternoon or evening, most of the medications are working round the clock. Now, these medications are designed to provide glucose lowering effect at the times when we are expecting peaks. Now, suppose somebody misses a meal and you already have drug levels in blood. So drug will push the glucose levels down. Somebody has not taken a meal, already at lower levels of glucose, it will push down further and person can get hypoglycemia or very low sugars, which can be dangerous. Similarly, somebody eats a large meal. Now you have given medication, say, to control the level to 160 after a meal of 50 grams carbohydrate. And somebody is consuming 100 grams carbohydrate. Now that 50 grams extra carbohydrate is going to large amount of sugar levels in blood and you will have a spike. Now, this is not just once this has happened. Now this spike is not neutralized. So before the next meal also your sugar levels are high and your medication is already, you know, at a level that it will control only some amount of sugar. So again, it will be insufficient. Suppose you have missed a meal. The amount of sugar that should be there is not there. So person goes into hypoglycemia. Now, once person is going into hypoglycemia, if the body mechanisms are working fine, it pushes the sugar back. So there is a rebound increase in glucose level. So the whole sugar levels start fluctuating and it becomes very difficult to control unless somebody is eating on time, eating consistently and eating as advised. Even if you change the composition of food, it will change the whole thing. See, wheat, from wheat you make dalia, from wheat you make the whole wheat flour, you make maida also. All three will give you a different rise in glucose because of the refining process. More refined foods you are taking, more is the higher level of glucose in response to that food, and faster it comes. If you are taking white flour or bread made of white flour, you will have a sharper increase in blood glucose and earlier. If you are having a whole wheat bread, then the rise will be slower and it will be smaller. Similarly, if you have a, you know, some bread mixed with other multigrains and dalia and coarse, grains, the sugar rise will be even smaller and further later. So all these things are important in, making sure that whatever food you are taking, it matches the action of the drugs that you are taking. And the balance between the drug action and food is very important to maintain a good glucose level.
So there are a few questions. Can I take them?
Yes, why not?
The first question is, these days potatoes with less glycemic index or low sugars like chipsona variety are available. Can it be taken freely? Could you allow a little good jaggery daily after meals? Whether late night dinner affects? Three questions.
So good and jaggery, Kavita already told, it can be taken, but small amount. You can't eat 100 grams of good after a meal. So it's a small bite just to increase the taste. And another important thing you should keep in mind is that sweet taste buds get sensitized once, then actually whatever you eat, it does not make difference. Like if you have had a sweet biscuit and then you take tea, you feel that tea doesn't have sugar because the taste buds are already sensitized. Similarly, you have taken a bite of jaggery. Next bite of jaggery is just maintaining your taste. It is not giving additional pleasure. So you should eat small and the taste will remain for quite some time. You don't need to eat extra sweets. Now, second thing is, these variety, low glycemic index variety of potatoes, and there is LGI variety of rice also. They are better than the regular ones, but the amounts, any food, item, if you are increasing the amount of intake, it is going to change your glucose profiles. It is going to impact it. Third thing is late night eating. Yes, there is some evidence emerging now that if you eat within, first 8 to 10 hours, within 8 to 10 hours of the daytime, it is, better for health. Now, important thing is, this is called time restricted eating, that you ate, and they call it intermittent fasting also. They call 8-16 plan, that 8 hours you eat, 16 hours you fast. But it is not good for diabetes patients because they are on medications which have effect going 24 hours. So normally we want them to eat 3 meals in the duration of about 12 hours, 10 to 12 hours. So breakfast at 9, dinner at 9. And a lunch in between some point of time, and 2 mid-meal snacks. And even, if we have, there is slightest amount of apprehension that this person can have hypoglycemia, we advise them to take a small cup of milk or a fruit before they go to sleep, just to make sure that they don't get hypoglycemia. So that time-restricted eating or intermittent fasting may not be appropriate for all diabetes patients. With some medications, there may not be any issue, but large number of medications, there can be a problem. So they have to, if they want to practice intermittent fasting or time-restricted eating, they should do it only in consultation with their physician, not otherwise.
The next question is, how to manage diet when there is limited physical activity for the patient due to age? Should the person still continue to have a normal diet?
See, diet, any healthy diet or normal diet is what is required for every individual. Only thing is now the amount of calories that is to be recommended for an individual, and it depends on whether the individual is sedentary or active or very active. So a sedentary person will require about 20 calories per kg per day. Moderate activity individual will require 25 calories per kg per day, and person performing, you know, more vigorous activities may need anything between 30 to 40 kilocalories per kg per day. So it depends on what kind of activity you have, but the food choices and the food, the portion sizes and everything works on the same basic principles.
Personally, I feel if the physical activity of a patient or a person goes down, definitely the appetite also goes down.
So it, important thing is physical activity goes down because of a physical limitation is something different. Age is no constraint for performing physical activity. Yes. And you know, we have some of the patients coming walking comfortably alone to our clinic for follow-up at the age of 94 right. years or 95 years also. And these people are better than those who have limitations at 60 years. So if somebody is physically active, the chances of having problems is decreased, especially in old age. And I want to make this point very clear for everyone that there are a number of studies which have very clearly shown that exercise should be performed moderately vigorous physical activity equal to brisk walk or cycling or swimming should be performed by all individuals at all ages to maintain good health. And alternate day, person should perform some amount of, stretching exercise or small, moderate, mild muscle training also to keep a good muscle mass. And they are the, there is one apprehension that person can get injured because of the age or, instability and things like that. You have to take care of that. But overall data is very clear that despite the risk of these injuries, the benefit risk ratio is in favor of doing regular exercise at all ages. So there is no age where a person should not be exercising regularly.
Next question is having coconut water better than having juices? And what's your take on cold pressed juices?
So no juices are good for, my take is no juices are good for nobody. So whether you are diabetic or you are not diabetic, the minute you convert a fruit or vegetable into juice, you throw out a lot of fiber, a lot of minerals with them, a lot of vitamins with them, which are very good for health. And you are taking the liquid concentrate of whatever you have from that vegetable or fruit. So if you are taking a fruit juice, you have a concentrated liquid sugar, which will give you a very sharp rise to glucose levels. If you are taking a vegetable juice, you have a lot of salt and which may not be good for your health. And usually they add some salt to vegetable juice. So excess salt intake is never good for health. Second thing is, if you are taking one glass of juice, you will need 3 or 4 oranges, right? So calories will be 4 times than of a single fruit. But if you consume maybe 2 oranges, you will feel full. You will have less calories, more fiber, less glucose rise, and so on. Similarly, to have a glass of juice, maybe you will, need a kilo of vegetable. But you eat only 250 grams of vegetables, you will feel full and have less of more of fiber and vitamins and minerals. So I think juice is no way better than vegetable or fruits. Ideally, as Kavita mentioned, we should use the whole grains, whole fruits, whole vegetables as source of our food, not the refined things. And juice is one of the most refined forms of vegetable and fruit.
And coconut water we can take.
Coconut water is good for health. So not a problem because it's, it's more of water and electrolytes.
Yes.
But it is not necessary that you take coconut water daily basis. And that is only thing that will improve your health.
The next question is diet recommended for children. And it's about your thoughts on increasing presence of junk food.
So junk food does not mean only pizzas and burgers. We have Indian junk food like chola bhatura, samosa, everything. There are all junk foods. Homemade puri aloo are also junk food. Homemade samosas are also junk food. Pakodas are also junk food. So any junk food by convention means, calorie dense foods that we are taking. For children, we have to take into account the growth and the protein requirement, and we have to give them extra calories as per the recommendations for a particular age. But the basic principle remains same, that we should give them, you know, more of whole grains, whole fruits rather than juices, and avoid calorie dense foods. But calorie calculation, calorie intake calculation will depend on what age we are calculating that, what is the body weight of the child, and what are the growth requirements.
And physical activity also, how much
everything has to be taken into account.
The next question is, should mixtures such as Horlicks, Boost, etc. be given to children irrespective of the sugar content?
So if the child has diabetes, you have to see what amount of calories you are adding and what is the source of calories. Even the if you look at the, you know, Boost and Bonvita high protein or Horlicks high protein, the average calories coming from protein are only about 8%. 90% of the calories or 95% of the calories are coming from carbohydrate. So only if you want to use them as taste or taste enhancement or flavoring agent, you know, small teaspoon is not a problem. But if you are giving it 2 scoops full or 3 scoops full, add it to a glass of milk in the attempt that it will improve the, you know, strength or energy, I don't think it has much difference, much, you know, relevance. You have to make sure that it fits very much within the caloric intake that is required and is given and distributed in small portions rather than one large, you know, serving.
Another very important point which we need to focus on is diet. With a diet in patients with diabetes on fasting days, when they are in fasting state, how do you manage it?
Kavita.
Yes, sir. So there are patients who regularly keep fast, but my advice is that you should not remain empty stomach for longer periods. We can include fruits in our diet. We can have a portion of milk. We can have if we want to have potato, we can have half or medium sized boiled potato in our diet. So idea is we should not, we can have salads also. We can have dairy products, skimmed, made from skimmed milk. So we should not keep, we should not have long gaps in the fasting days also. हमको कुछ ना कुछ ले लेना चाहिए which is very much in our including in our diet.
So would you like to add something regarding medication?
So I think most important thing Kavita earlier also mentioned is that ideally we should not advise them to fast. But, you know, fast is more of a religious trip. That is fine, and unless, you know, it should be in consultation with the treating physician, because he or she knows best. That whether these medications will cause hypoglycemia or no. If there is potential to cause hypoglycemia, medication will need to be changed on the fasting days, and that will definitely, you know, disturb the glucose levels. So best is not to fast if you can do with that. If you have to fast, there are some religious periods like, you know, Navratras or Ramadan, that people will fast, or the eating behavior will change during Ramadan. They eat, you know, in the evening and early morning. So the whole eating system moves from daytime to nighttime. So dosing system has to change. So all these things have to be kept in mind.
So now a last question to both of you is, any tips to my patients for managing diabetes and diet?
Yes, I have a list of tips which I generally give to my patients.
Please.
First is, start your meals with healthy salads. Eat lot of green veggies. You can add sprouts, chanas in your mid-meal snacks. Whole grain cereals, whole grain pulses should be added. Remove refined flour. Extra packaged or processed foods should be avoided. Read your food labels, that how much calories you are having. Use skimmed milk. Remove starch from rice. Have small and frequent meals. and sugar monitoring is important, and most important is physical activity for at least 1 hour. So that these are the major tips.
Great. Sir, would you like to add anything?
No, I think these are the basic things. And the important thing is, you know, the first, when we started, the comment was that eat consistently, eat on time, don't skip your meals, avoid all kinds of free sugars and free fats. And that is what a healthy diet is, and that is what a healthy eating pattern is. Of course, I strongly feel that all diabetes patients should consult a dietitian to have a structured diet plan which goes with their medication plan, so that they have a better control of glucose levels.
True, sir. So in the end, I would like to sum up today's session by just saying, being a diabetic, it doesn't mean that you should give up the joy of eating, but be judicious, be selective, know your food, read your labels, consult your doctor and dietitian, and enjoy your life.
Yes, correct.
So let's sum up the session today, sir.
Yes, I think we can end this. If there are no more questions.
I'll just check.
So with this, we come to end of this session. Thank you all once again for joining our Facebook Live educational programs, and hope you are getting what you look for from these programs. I hope these small educational initiatives are helping you manage your diabetes, weight, and general health better. And in this, we will continue with this endeavor on an ongoing basis. So hope to see you again on next Thursday at 3 p.m. Thank you so much.
Thank you, everyone.
Have a good day.